was scared of dentists and the dark. I was scared of pretty girls and starting conversations. All my friends are turning green. Yeah, the magician's assistant in their dream. Oh,
hi, my name is Sammy.
Hi, my name Prayitno.
Hi, my name is Ri.
Hi, my name Abisai.
Hi, my name is Jason Liu.
So I've been here 11 years in Bali.
Yeah.
For nearly 6 months.
Yeah.
2 years.
Yes.
Last 2 years, yeah.
Hampir 4 tahun.
What work do you do in the kitchen?
I'm as translator here.
Yeah.
And then sometimes I'm organized for student doing photocopy.
Yeah.
Prepare for all staff for student.
Okay.
Yeah.
For the last 5 years, I've been bringing occupational therapy students from Curtin University in Perth here. And they've been doing one of their practical experiences here with the children, local children.
Yeah. Saya membantu student untuk translate. Dan juga kadang mengajari mereka bahasa Indonesia untuk bisa berkomunikasi dengan anak-anak.
Yeah.
Juga jika tidak ada student, saya juga membantu terapi untuk mereka.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, I work with them because I enjoy it. It's actually the thing that keeps me in Bali. Yeah. Not the counseling so much, but the work with the children. One of the reasons I really love it is because we're so appreciated by the kids and the families. Like,
yeah, the kids here, I love to give them like advice that I expected they can change their life when they leave from here.
Saya suka untuk membantu mereka karena kebanyakan mereka tidak terjangkau atau jarang orang untuk bisa membantu. Jadi karena saya sedikit punya pelajaran untuk terapi, saya juga membantu terapi mereka agar mereka lebih bangga dan tidak malu kepada orang yang akan datang melihat mereka.
Yeah.
Jadi lebih memperkuat feeling mereka dan tidak merasa takut walaupun mereka kekurangan fisik.
Yeah. Because in Indonesia, especially khusus for Indonesia, there's not many people take care for the kid like disability.
Yeah.
Yeah. The first time I see some kid that's not really good.
Yeah.
So, for example, like the kid always crying, or cannot doing therapy, always hard to find them to go to therapy room.
Yeah.
But now I see lots better.
A lot.
Yeah. Can do anything.
Okay.
Some of the children we can help, like we can see functional improvement, and it's really, really gratifying to be able to see that. Even if the improvement with a child with a severe disability is small,
yeah,
it still can mean a lot to the child and to the family.
Mm-hmm.
For those children, we still do a really important job. We improve the quality of their life.
Yeah.
So, for example, we've had children here that have spent, until we started coming, have spent their whole time lying on their back just looking at a ceiling.
Mm-hmm.
And now those children are positioned so they can see things around them. They're stimulated in all different ways.
Yeah.
They find meaning and purpose in things that they're able to do independently or with help.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the children we see cannot get out and don't ever get out. Like, they just stay in the room or in the house. So for those children, we try to bring their world to them. So we bring things in so that they can experience what other children might be experiencing in their daily life.
Yeah.
Karena mereka juga tidak bisa beraktivitas seperti anak-anak biasanya. Jadi saya coba memberikan pelajaran atau kita nggak tahu di pikiran mereka, mereka ingin seperti apa nantinya. Ya, jadi saya mau membantu mereka untuk lebih baik, walaupun tidak sesempurna anak-anak seperti biasa.
I think the prac in Bali is very unique in a sense that you have more freedom to practice the way you want to. Like you have more freedom to try the things that you want to and be very creative and innovative with like the types of therapy activities that you do. And it also gives the kids the opportunity to try a lot of things and like just have fun.
Why do you think more students should come to Bali on prac?
You have way more independence and you need a lot more self-guidance and self-control rather than in guided prac. During therapy sessions, we are there just with the therapy assistant and the child, so you really run the show 100% of the time. I think it gives you a lot of confidence, self-confidence that you are a therapist rather than just a student. Learning how to be a therapist, you are an actual, like, you are practicing as a therapist here.
I hope Sally can get more students from another country.
Yeah.
Can help a kid in Bali.
Okay.
So they can, because the family here,
yeah,
hard paying
therapy
here.
Yeah.
Not many people also doing therapy here.
Okay.
So I hope Sally can get more students or participants can come to Bali and helping the kid here.
Okay.
Yeah.
We're kids again. We'd hang out almost every day, running through woods at dawn, finding the magic in things. And you'd help me climb the trees, pulling me up to the top of the branches. You'd open your book to read the story that felt like we were already in. Where you're the king of the apple trees, in the orchard where I'd come to eat. Where we'd pull the wings off bees to build a bed in the top of the barn, and humming through grass we'd sing. Out in the fields with the wind in our ears, where nights are long and in the day, you'd paint and I'd write about outer space. Where I'm the queen of the creek and the banks where you would come to drink. Birch and bark, I tell you my secrets of how I can fly, and I'll show you how tonight. Over bread and some white wine on ice, so I'll draw a bath and we'll cram in. Thank you.
Last year, a friend of mine donated another $1,000, which kept us going with the small things that we need, just bit by bit.
Yep.
And then he passed away from motor neurone disease last year. He'd lived in Bali a long time. And he left a bequest of $1,000, which we're now going to offer as a scholarship for students. So we're trying to, by that, encourage more students to come, because if we don't have students, we don't have therapy. So sometimes we have a gap where there's no students, and that gap can be even 6 months. And it's very hard to say to a family that we don't have anyone that can see their child.
Yeah.
So hopefully the scholarship, in the name of my friend who was Jamie Crow, will be called the Jamie Crow Scholarship. Hopefully that will encourage more students to apply, because they may be successful in gaining the scholarship. So I'd like to see something that was sustainable and something that could happen even if we didn't have students.
Yeah.
And the idea that I have is that we would train local people to be therapy assistant. So my idea is that we would train local people to be the therapy assistant. We've already done that with one person, you know. But the problem is we don't have someone that could pay his salary as yet.
Yeah.
But that's what I'm hoping for, that we could fundraise to have enough money to pay Yitno's salary so he could see the children when we don't have students.
Yeah.
And also that we could train more people, and of course we could see more children, because at the moment we can only see as many children as we've got students.
Yeah.
So I'm sure there's a lot more kids out there who need therapy.
Cool.
Yeah, I'd just like to say thank you to all the students that have been here. We've had 70 in the last 5 years, and I'd like to thank them for their hard work that they did at the time they were here and that they continue to do by keeping in touch. And I'd also like to thank all of the sponsors who've given us money to support the kids over time.
Thank you.
Woo!
Shakila, suka? Suka, pusing-pusing? Suka?
Yeah.
Suka. Okay. Nah, main dengan kawan. Situ.